Hi, everybody. Thanks so much for tuning in. I'm really happy to be able to present a few of the works I've written this year on this virtual program. For those of you who are able to and inclined to make a donation to support me and the other performers, that would be tremendously appreciated, and there's information below in the YouTube description. There's also links to my Patreon and to a page on my website to learn more about how we might be able to work together. So a little bit about the program. At the beginning of the year, I was really interested in returning to the art song genre, which I had not really explored for quite a while. So I started talking to some singers, I started exploring some poetry, and I started talking to some people who could sponsor some song cycles. And so the first cycle that I wrote, which is the first large piece on this program after a little prelude, is called As If Saying Goodbye, and it's a cycle of five songs that I wrote for mezzo-soprano Emily Hughes on poems by Andrea Cohen. So I came across Andrea Cohen's work really purely by accident. I happened to see one of her poems on my Twitter feed, and so I took a screenshot and held on to it. This was a couple years ago, but that became then my starting point when I started looking for poetry. And I just found her work really tremendously compelling and really precise and kind of pristine. And so I was very happy to be able to get in touch with her and to have her enthusiasm for this project. So while I was actually researching this first song cycle, a mutual friend actually connected me to the work of Ben Purkert. So I went to his website and looked at his poetry, and I thought, yeah, this could be a really different sort of challenge, different type of writing to kind of immerse myself in and see what I can create. This ended up becoming a song cycle called The Water Around Our Lives, setting three of his poems for tenor Nils Neubert. And so that is the closer to tonight's program. And then between those pieces is a work for dance. And those of you who know me know that I've done a lot of work with dance over the years. And early in quarantine, around the end of March, I put out a call to choreographers saying, hey, we're all just sort of stuck right now. If you'd like to work on a piece, a short piece for piano, then let me know. This would be a way to just connect and create and see what we can do while we're also isolated from each other. This became what I've called my Ipseities project, and it's gotten really quite big. There are, at this point, 20 pieces, 13 finished, and 20 in total that are accounted for, each a collaboration with a different choreographer, a pair of choreographers. I think I'm going to aim for a nice even 24. So the project is still in progress, but we'll be presenting one of the pieces tonight, and it's the 13th one. And I wrote this for Jenna Charko, who has created a dance film that she made at a park in New Jersey. So that has sort of become the oasis of nature and movement in between the song cycles. And then there's another piece that I have sprinkled around a little bit in the program. I've been spending a little bit more time on Twitter the past couple of years because I discovered a really wonderful and welcoming new music community there. So I got the idea that it might be fun to make a piece at the setting of a bunch of tweets by this particular LA-based comedic writer and performer, Danielle Weisberg. So I reached out to Danielle to get her permission. I also spoke with soprano Zen Wu, who I'd also met originally on Twitter, because I thought it might be a nice fit for her. And basically I just thought this would be a really fun project. And it was. So the piece ended up becoming a setting of 30 tweets. We have not been able to record all of them. We recorded as much as we could when the COVID numbers were down. As they started to rise, we thought, okay, well, let's put this off for a little while. But we've got 19 of the 30 tweets to share on this program. And I've broken them up a bit to be sort of preludes and interstitials between the other pieces on the program. So I think these will be a little entertaining palate cleanser between the other pieces. And before I forget, for those of you who like to follow along with the text when listening to art songs, because we don't have a program, you know, a printed program that lists all the texts, if you click on the closed captioning button on YouTube, then the texts will appear during the vocal works, and so you can follow along that way. So I think that's about it. Hope you enjoy the program.
Today I had a perfect day. if anyone needs anything. What's it called when you have no self-esteem, but also think you're better than everyone? Sorry for the face I made in your general direction when I was inventing a scenario in my head that will never happen, and reacting to someone dissing me in that scenario. Reminder that when you don't invite me to a party, you are rude, but also correct. Anxiety is like having no object permanence, but with your
Rupert. Thank you.
get married to get divorced. I don't want to get married, but I do think I would make an excellent divorcee.
At night, everything feels, even a river feels its way through the woods, mumbling, slight edge in its voice, enough to pry the sky open a crack, then light through the haze, the earth covers its face with brush, black stones elbow each other inside a divide the world into two types of people. One blankets my streets, the other paves them right over. I once saw a comedy where the tuba in a marching band trips, and his fellow instruments go on trampling him.
Thank you.
Thank you all so much for watching. I would like to thank the other performers, Emily Hughes, Nils Neubert, Zen Wu, and Jenna Charko. They all put in a tremendous amount of work and energy to make this program possible. I would like to thank the poets, the authors of the texts, Andrea, Ben, and Danielle for allowing me to use their words. I would like to thank Martha Rhodes from Four Way Books. I would like to thank Sangeeta Yesli and the staff at Dixon Place for letting us have a recording session at Dixon Place. I'd also like to thank the sponsors who underwrote the commissions for these pieces. Jerry Appelstein, Teresa Huntsman, Lisa Carlson, Charles and Deborah Edelman, Martin Pico, Elizabeth Falk, and Max Sternville, as well as those who have supported my work this year, not on this program, because there are certainly more people who have helped, and it is a tremendous help, especially now during this period. And that's about it. Thanks so much, and take care, everybody.